Yes, yes, my dear students. Today I will start another topic of the gram positive decile. That is again very important from the examination point of view, from your BCQ point of view, from your OSP point of view, from your interactive point of view, from the short essay point of view. हर चीज को डिस्कशन करेंगे. आज मैं इनका पोस्टमार्टम करके रखूंगा. Let us talk on the very important topic, that is Carnibacteria dipteri. Next please. Yes. Carnibacterium dipteri. First of all, we will discuss what are the pseudo membrane forming microalgae. Why? Because Carnibacterium dipteri is one of the microorganism, strong microorganism, which is strong exotoxin producing organism, as well as it forms the pseudo membrane in the mouth or the pharynx. So today we will discuss what are the other microorganisms which lead to the pseudo membrane formation, are known as the pseudo membrane forming microorganism. जैसे Carnibacter diphtheri है, Candida albicans है, Clostridium difficile है. जैसे Candida albicans, in case of the overuse of the antibiotics, which leads to the formation of the white thrush in the mouth, that leads to the pseudo membrane formation. So this is also organism which takes part in the pseudo membrane forming microorganism. And Clostridium difficile, which forms a pseudo membrane over the colon, that is known as the pseudo membranous colitis. In the old days, that was concept that this pseudo membranous colitis is associated only with the clindamycin, or the market name of this antibiotic is Delacin C. So nowadays it is proved that all the antibiotics mostly lead to the formation of the pseudo membranous colitis. So these are the microorganisms which are known as the pseudo membrane forming microorganism. Sometimes interactive question is asked in this. Name the pseudo membrane forming microorganism, or name one of the fungi which take part in the formation of the pseudo membrane, that is Candida albicans. That can ask even BCQ from the three type of the microorganisms. Next please. Powerful exotoxin producing organism. Why? Because this Carnibacter diphtheri is a strong, powerful exotoxin producing organism. So what are the other organisms which are also known as the powerful exotoxin producing organism? Carnibacter diphtheri, Clostridium tetani, Vibrio cholera, and Shigella dysentery. So these are the organisms. These again question asked in your interactive question. Name the powerful exotoxin producing organism. Next please. What are the distinguishing features, are the popular features, are the well known things regarding the Carnibacter diphtheri? We have already discussed that Bacillus species and Clostridium species, these are the gram positive bacilli which are deeply stained. Carnibacter diphtheri, they appear club shaped or the Chinese letter type appearance. Listeria monocytogenes appear V or L shaped rods. So these are the some of the dominant features of these gram positive bacilli. Next please. These are the gram positive bacilli with Chinese letter club shape appears. I will show you the how they look like a Chinese letter or the club shape appears. We will see a very good picture in case of the staining. It is a powerful exotoxin producing organism, non-capsulated, non-motile, non-spore forming facultative anaerobic organism. Humans are the only host for the Carnivectra diphtheriae. The common site of the Carnivectra diphtheriae, they reside in the upper respiratory tract. Carnivectra diphtheriae are in the V or A shape type of the formations. Mostly they look like a club shape or the Chinese type of the letters. Route of transmission. These are transmitted in the air through the airborne droplets. These organisms, Carnivectra diphtheriae, leads to the formation of the pseudomyelin. Beta, these are the type of the BC could be question also. If you have to write a short note on the Carnivectra diphtheriae, then these distinct features are sufficient to write the short note on Carnivectra diphtheriae. Next, please. After the infection of the Carnivectra diphtheriae or the diphtheria, this occurs mostly in the children. So the bull neck appearance, I will show you the very good picture of the bull neck appearance. These are the lysogenic bacteria. Where these are known as the lysogenic bacteria, I will explain it. They contain volutin granules. These are also known as the metachromatic granules. What is the definition of the metachromatic or the volutin granules? Granules stain red and the rest of the cell is blue. What is the function of these granules? These are the energy storing substances. These granules are particularly seen from the culture media that is known as the Lafleur's serum agar culture medium and Dorset egg medium are on the one of the common staining which can diagnose the Carnivectra diphtheriae in 10 minutes that is known as the methylene blue staining or the Albert stain. So these are the two of the staining methods which are used to visualize and see the red granules. Next please. What is lysogen? An antigen inducing the formation of the lysin. Lysin is known as the antibody. Means lysin, antibody capable of causing the dissolution of the cells like hemolysin and the bacterial. Next, please. Very good picture of this club shape appearance. You see a very good picture, the green with the black head. And another, the Carnivectra diphtheriae, the club shape, swollen ends at the one end, a very clear picture on the staining procedure. Next, please. You see here the Chinese type letters, the third one, grams staining. These are the beaded appearance like this. Next, please. Risk factors. Who can suffer from the Carnivectra diphtheriae? Outbreak in the community. Crowded or unsanitary living conditions. Immunity gaps in the adults. Means adults are deficient in the immunity or the defense power. Lack of mass immunization programs or the lack of the vaccines, especially among the children and the adults are at the higher risk. Lack of the vaccines in the many areas. Next, please. What response to the Carnivectra diphtheriae? How this pseudomembrane formation takes place? Local inflammation in the throat due to the irritation of this microorganism lead to the pseudomembrane formation. Second, antibody that can neutralize the exotoxin by blocking the interaction of the fragment B with the receptor, thereby preventing the entry into the cell. Next, please. Clinical manifestation of the pseudomembrane formation. What are the features of the pseudomembrane? Word pseudo means false. Pseudo refers to the abnormal nature of the membranes in contrast to the normal anatomic membranes of the body, such as the normal tympanic membrane and normal placental membrane. So false means unnatural membrane on mucosal surfaces of the throat that is caused by the carnivacteria and on the unnatural membrane on the mucosal surface of the colon that is known as the pseudomembranous colitis. And third one is yes. This is a very good picture of the cervical lymph adenopathy leading to the neck swelling, a huge swelling. So we can keep the slide in your forthcoming post-P examination. We'll keep this slide and ask you the clinical manifestation or the causative agent of this cervical lymph adenopathy. Characteristic features of the pseudomembrane. Pseudomembrane is a thick, adherent, grayish or yellowish exudate on the both mucosal surfaces. So due to the formation of the pseudomembrane lead to the three prominent complications in the throat. Number one, extension of the membrane into the larynx and the trachea, which lead to the airway obstruction. Number two, myocarditis, a company which leads to the erythema, circulatory collapse. Third one, nerve weakness or paralysis of the cranial nerve of the soft palate and the pharynx. That will lead to the regurgitation of the fluid through the nose. So these are the three complications associated with the pseudomembrane formation. They can ask a question in the examination, or I think they can give in the BCQ, which one of the serious complications of the pseudomembrane which lead to the airway or the trachea obstruction. Next, please. You see a pseudomembrane, a very good picture in the throat, a little formation over the tongue at the pharynx. Next, please. Another picture, clear cut pseudomembrane obstructing the airway means a serious complication of the pseudomembrane. Next, please. Again, a grayish, thick, adherent membrane, which is known as the pseudomembrane. Next, please. See the bull neck appearance. A child or the baby suffering from the carnivacteria infection. Another, you can see a pseudomembrane, grayish or the yellowish in color, obstructing the airway or the trachea, which leads to the airway obstruction. Next, please. It also causes peripheral neuritis, affecting the muscles of the extremities and cutaneous diphtheria that causes the ulceration in the skin covered with the gray membrane. Next, please. Laboratory diagnosis consists of the two parameters, means isolation of the microorganisms. What are the parameters which are used for the isolation of the microorganism? First of all, we will do the staging procedure, means just to see the morphology. We will perform a staining test which can diagnose carnivacterial victory within 10 minutes. That is known as the simple methylene blue staining. Second one is the Albert stain, just to see the red granules of this particular organism. We will do the culture of the following media: Loeffler's serum agar, which is the type of the enriched medium; Dorset egg medium, which is the type of the enriched medium; Tellurite blood agar, which is the type of the enriched medium; and Tinsdale medium, Probably it is a selective type of the culture media which is used for the growth of the army materiality. Yes, what is number two, demonstration of the exotoxin. We perform the following test in case of the carny diphtheria for its identification. Number one, we perform an elec gel precipitation test. This test is used to detect the toxin, diphtheria toxin, which consists of the tox gene. We also perform an animal inoculation test. We will take a positive culture of the carny diphtheria and inject to the guinea pig or the rabbit that will expire or die within the 72 hours. Means he was sensitive with the carny diphtheria. If this test is positive, means patient is suffering from the diphtheria infection. PCR, that is also used for the detection of the tox gene. It is composition of the diphtheria toxin. Another laboratory donated biochemical test, kidney test, and DNA test, both are positive. Oxygen test, negative. Urea test, negative. Ferment glucose and maltose acid production. Few strains of the bioreactor of the ferment. Sucrose, such as the two of the species of the Carnivora diphtheria gravis and the maltose, which are known as the sucrose fermenter organism. Assessment of the immune status of the patient. A patient suffering from the Carnivora diphtheria, I will confirm that it has antibody or without antibody. We will perform a Schick test. This test is carried out for the assessment of the immune status. Injection of the 0.1 milliliter of the purified diphtheria toxin. If the patient has no antitoxin, means no antibody, then toxin will cause inflammation at the site. In the 4 to 7 days, means a Schick test is positive. Positive means patient is already positive with the antibody against the carny diphtheria. If no inflammation occurs, it means antitoxin. Antitoxin means antibody is present and test is negative. Purpose of the treatment, that inhibit the growth of organism. Number two, they reduce the toxin production. Number three, decrease the incidence of the chronic carriers. Next, please. Thank you very much. And I will start another topic. Today, we have completed the gram-positive bacilli. So I will again start the gram-negative bacilli. Especially the largest group of the bacilli. First of all, I will classify the gram-negative bacilli. Then we will start a big group of the gram-negative bacilli that is known as the enterobacteria. Please wait a while. Yes.